Hey guys, this is Elliot the iPad Pro, and this is a fast video where I show the updated way to install I/O. So the way that I showed how to install I/O in this video is actually out of date and will not work anymore. So from now on, my channel's homepage will always show the latest way to install I/O. Also, in all of my videos, I'll be putting updates inside the comments, so make sure to always check out the comments when you're watching a video. Okay, so how do we actually install I/O? Well, luckily, we install it basically the exact same way as before, but with just a few minor changes. So after you create a Google Cloud account, you again go to Compute Engine, and then you create a new VM instance. Like before, you can name the instance whatever you like My First I/O. We then click Deploy Container Image. But now for the first big change, instead of typing gcr.io/pupster, what we're going to type now is just pupster90/io. Then we click Advanced Container Options and we check the three checkboxes. Under Command, we type tiny and then we click Add Argument. Then we type minus g and we click Add Argument again. Then we type password and we click Add Argument. Then you can type your password, but make sure to not use any quotation marks or spaces. Then we scroll down to boot disk, and like before, we're going to change it to an SSD drive with 30 gigabytes. Now, under Firewall, we click the two checkboxes. And finally, we click Create. And that's it. This is the new way to create I/O. And like before, after you wait 10 or 15 minutes, you can go to the external website shown right there, and then you'll come to your Jupyter website. From there, you can type your password and start using Jupyter. So, sorry if you had any trouble installing the software. From now on, I'll put updates like this in the video's description. Also, be on the lookout for any glitch fix videos like this that will give you updates. All right, this is Elliot the iPad Pro. See you guys next video.